welcome to Beautiful Snow TV. Welcome back, Snowflakes, and welcome if you are new. Make sure you guys hit the subscribe button and don't forget to put your post notifications on so you don't miss another time when I upload. And here are all the products we're going to be using today. It's not a lot. I'm also going to go ahead and link the airbrush that I used in the video today, as you guys saw by that beautiful thumbnail. We're going to be doing some butterfly nails today. I am going to start doing Valentine's sets. Don't worry. That's literally the next set that's coming up. But I just want to go ahead and try to do some sets that I want to do here on the channel based on what I like. So I'm going to go ahead and start with the products. And these are always linked down below. Always make sure you check the description box for anything that you might want to purchase. And you can also purchase these things through my Amazon storefront. They are always linked below. So let's go ahead and get started. We're gonna go in with the polygel application. This is a polygel application. I am getting so much better with my application. Fouling has become less and less. I really am so proud of myself for perfecting my application. This manicure stick, if y'all have not gotten this after I don't know how many times I've said it, y'all should go ahead and cop one of these. This is such a easy tool to use. It makes molding polygel and application of polygel so much easier. Like, it's so more controlled. I have no idea what the trick is, but I use the same motions I use with a brush, but this is obviously with a wooden manicure stick, and it just works so much better. Once you try it, you'll understand the magic and you'll be part of the team. Like, come on, girls. So I'm just gonna go ahead with the polygel application on the thumb, and let's go ahead and let you guys watch this process. And all of the polygel application is done. They are looking so good, guys. That is just the excess peel off base around my cuticles. It usually gets filed off, I'm gonna go ahead and start with the filing process. I'm gonna go ahead and take a 180 grit and an 80-80 grit and a buffer there, and I'm just gonna go ahead and take my trusty dusty nail dust collector and just go ahead and get the filing. I have my e-file there as well, so cute. I'm just gonna go ahead and take a 5-in-1 bit. This is a medium fine bit, and I'm just gonna go over the cuticles. I don't use it quite often. I feel like these bits take a little bit too much off. I feel like they're more for acrylic. I am still learning things, as we all are, and I found out that there's a certain type of bit that you really want to go with when using gels, and there's a different one that you want to go with when using acrylic. So I use gels, polygel. I use gel X. So these are the things that I like. I feel like this carbine bit right here really does better with smoothing out the nail, working on the cuticle, sealing them. And that's just my personal opinion, you know, with working with these products and these drill bits. So I'm just going to go ahead and go around the cuticle, and then I'm going to go ahead and just kind of buff my cuticle area as well, just to get it really, really, you know, sealed in and everything. And then I'll go ahead and start the shaping. Now, shaping duck nails is very difficult for me. May not be for you, but it is for me. I do find it a little bit more challenging. The videos that I've watched, they are not really too much filing on the sides, and they really emphasize, you know, trying to keep the shape of the actual tip that you did place on the actual natural nail. And so that's really the trick to filing the duck nails. I learned that you could definitely file the sides if it's a straight edge, but I know some people taper in their duck nails. I have no idea how they file those, but I am just gonna go ahead and file the sides, and then I'll file the free edge as well. And all of the nails have been filed, shaped, and buffed, and I am loving that shape, y'all. I don't know if it's just because I did well on it to me, but we're gonna go ahead and start with the airbrush. So I have a tip: if you have an airbrush like this, make sure you clean out. I was practicing with mine, so mine was clean when I started. I just wanna make sure I got the right consistency. So you wanna put a few drops. I know some people are so against the airbrush, but I feel like there's nothing wrong with this airbrush or airbrushing your nails, period. I know some people say you have to use a certain paint, but I'm not paying $30-$40 for those little 10, you know, paint bottles that come in that one kit when I have hundreds of different variety of colors in gel polish, and I could just mix a little acetone. That's just my preference. You don't have to follow my preference. This is just a reference if you want this particular look. Now, you can use a sponge or a what you call that thing, a little cotton like a makeup sponge should get the airbrushed effect as well. Or you can even use a fan art brush, a fan art nail brush that you can get really cheap. Sometimes they come in, you know, little kits when you buy them for nail stuff. You could use that as well to get the aura effect. But to me, I wanted to buy an airbrush. I thought it was so cool. But that is how I achieve my airbrushed look with the airbrush there. I just mix a little bit of gel polish and a couple drops of acetone, makes it really, really good, and make sure the consistency. I tested on the paper towel before I do spray the nail, but here I'm gonna go ahead and paint the nail that orange color, beautiful orange from Roslyn, and then I'll go ahead and do the jelly on top of it. I felt like this one was like slightly bright and I didn't have an in-between color, so I did go ahead and use a jelly color just to kind of darken it, and I felt like it gave a great effect. Thank you. And here I'm just gonna go ahead and do my index finger and my ring finger in a French with that beautiful orange color. And I'll do the same process as I did to the thumb, applying that jelly on top as well in the French mode. And then I'll be curing all of my gel polish for 30 to 60 seconds in between applying the gel. So as you see here, I'm gonna go ahead and apply that jelly color, and then I'll go ahead and cure for a full 60. I'm just gonna go ahead and take my airbrush machine with my lighter orange color, and I'll just go ahead and kind of test it on the paper towel there, and I'll go ahead and start spraying the nails. Now once you get it to your desired look of the aura nail, then you can go on and cure that for a full 60 seconds. Sometimes it kind of splatters out, y'all, because it'd be coming out too fast, so I have to test it on the paper towel, but it's giving a beautiful seamless look, y'all, and I am loving it. Now the trick to airbrush is that you want to kind of pull back softly on the trigger. You don't want it to, you know, kind of come out too fast. And we're gonna go ahead and take some of that Beatles black. I love this black. It's very pigmented, it's very thick. You know, you can always use a thin layer, but I love this black. So I'll go ahead and take my liner brush. This is one of my long liner brushes. I don't know the size of this. I got this from Amazon. This is also gonna be linked in my Amazon storefront. So this, I'm just gonna go ahead and take the, we're doing a butterfly design. So I'm just gonna go ahead and take the black and the liner brush and just kind of randomly put the butterfly design. I'm gonna try to explain it. So you see where you don't want them to be straight 90 degree angles. Like, you want them to have curve to actually insinuate the butterfly effect or their wings or their pattern on their wings. I felt like this was really, really fun to do. This was so, so cool. And whoever came up with this design, kudos to them, because this is such a cute design. It's so girly. It's giving spring, but you know, we still cold out here in Texas, but I'm still going to do butterfly nails. But so how I did this, I just kind of rounded. As you can see, I'm kind of rounding like the curves in the nail, well, in the design. I don't want them to be harsh lines. Like, I don't want it to be like straight A and things like that. So I did go ahead and finish that one. I'm going to go ahead and do, y'all, I need to get something for my nail to stand on, well, sit on while I'm doing this so I can stabilize my hand. I have my AirPod case right there. So I'm just going to go ahead and do the designs on all of the nails. And you want to make your lines thick enough, not too thick to where it looks like abstract art to a certain extent, but you want to make them thick enough to where when you go back in and put your white dots to give the butterfly effect of their wings to where it'll look like a butterfly. So I did go ahead and cure in between each nail. I don't know how to explain how I curve the middle. Y'all can kind of get the gist of what I'm doing. So as you see there, I was trying to find what angle I wanted to, you know, pull the lines from. But you see how I'm pulling them straight from that line? I'm going to go in and kind of curve that line in the middle there, right there. And I'm just going to go ahead and curve it. That's the only way I know how to explain it, guys. I didn't want them to seem really harsh because butterflies don't really have harsh lines. So that's just the way I can explain. I'm gonna stop rambling and let y'all watch this process. And here I did go ahead and finish all the black. So I'm gonna go ahead and take that Beatles white, and I use white a lot, y'all. That little dot wasn't gonna do it, so I turned it upside down and just kind of let it sit there and, you know, got what I needed from it. So I did go ahead after the video and clean that. I just felt it was really gross. I have OCD, y'all. I'm so sorry. But I'm just gonna take my smallest dotting tool. As I said before, this is where those sticker lines come into play. And as soon as you see me put the dots on here, you can kind of see the butterfly effect coming in. This is so, so cute. I've been waiting for a long time to do these nails. I wanted to get Christmas and, you know, all those other nails out the way. You know, I want to kind of stay current with the trends. But I love this design, guys. This was so, so cute, so fire. I will be doing another one, but in a different color. Let me know in the comments what color you think I should do. I have some in mind. I have some pink, some green, some blues. I have some ideas. So let me know in the comments what y'all want to see next. And I'll go ahead and try to do those. But I'm just going to go ahead and finish up the dotting tool. And that just gave like the cutest effect, y'all. This is so, so cute. Like, this is so, so cute. And all of the dotting dots and all of the white is done on the nail. So I'm going to go ahead and take some rhinestone glue there. And I have all of my charm, well, some of my charms out. And I'm just going to go ahead and do some random placements to just kind of give that kind of junky but really, really cute. You know how they say the garden has a system but it's still messy? This is kind of what I was going for in my mind when I was placing my stones down. And I have like a bunch of charms here, just kind of going with the flow. I did not have a setup of how I wanted the stones to be placed. Like I said, I just went with the flow of what I wanted and felt that was really cute on the nail. So you just guys are going to just see me put these stones on. I have some AB stones there. I also have some white flowers. I also have those orange flowers that I showed at the beginning. And I also have some gold rhinestones that I got from the beauty supply store. Y'all, I was going in there for one thing and came out with like three. But I did not know this particular store had rhinestones, and they're cute. As y'all can see, they're really, really cute. You can't see them in the camera view, but as you can see, I'm placing them there on the nail, and they give like a very good shine to the nail, and it kind of insinuates the orange. It complements the orange. So I really, really like this gold rhinestones that I did get from the beauty supply store. Sorry I can't link it, guys, but yeah, some things I get from my beauty supply store. You know, you can get cheap nail products there too. I get acetone from there sometimes. I get like my dust off brushes. Just, you know, kind of go and walk around your local beauty supply store, and they have nail products for you to use. Nail polish remover. It's a bunch of other things. I actually got some chrome out of Dollar Tree. I should have filmed that. I was so in shock. I was just standing there looking. I was like, ain't no way Dollar Tree got chrome. But yes, they got nail chrome powder in there. Now, if they get some black gel polish, then and we in business. I'm going to do a Dollar Tree video, y'all. Let me know if y'all really want to see that in the comments. If y'all want to see me go to Dollar Tree, get some stuff, and make up a fire nail set, y'all let me know. Now, y'all are more than halfway through this video. Make sure you guys click on the subscribe button and support your girl for free. Thank you. And here is how the nails came out, guys. I am so pleased with the outcome. Sometimes I doubt myself, but I need to quit doing that because, you know, I don't know why I do that. I don't know. I guess I'd be scared to, like, try new things, but that is what life is all about. Trying something new, finding out what you're good at. You'll never know until you try, y'all. I am loving this. I almost didn't want to take these off. When I sent these to my manager, she was like, oh my gosh, you do such, like, she's like, why do you work here? Because you could be a nail tech. I'm like, yeah, I'm still learning. So I don't feel like I'm nail tech ready yet. I do some, you know, friends and family and clients' nails, but I just don't feel like I'm ready all the way. So we're going to go ahead and add some cuticle oil on there and just go ahead and nourish our cuticles and, you know, put some life back into these fingers because y'all, they've been through it. So we're just going to go ahead and add that cuticle oil and then we're going to go ahead and get the final shots. Guys, make sure you guys subscribe to the channel if you're new here, if you're loving this kind of content, the nails that I do, and want to see the future sets and see where this channel goes. And make sure you guys like the video. Make sure you guys comment. Don't be afraid to talk. I talk back, I promise. I am loving these, y'all. The little butterfly with the gold trim is just everything. Like, I feel like it didn't take away from it, y'all. I am just really, really loving these. Like, they are so, so cute. Ah, make sure y'all stay for those final shots. And I'll see you guys in the next one. Thank you.